Jesus, we love you so much. We love you so much, Lord. We love your name. We love your presence. We love your word. We love you. And we welcome you here right now. We don't beg you to show up, Lord. We confess and acknowledge that you are here right now. You are the ever-present help in time of trouble, and you are here right now. So receive our offering of worship and praise and adoration to you and to you alone, Lord Jesus.
Your glory. experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of open our eyes, see you, God. Let us become more aware of your presence.
Fill this place now.
Let us experience the glory of your goodness.
All I want.
Let us become more aware.
Verse 16, and when Jesus was baptized, immediately he went up from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and coming to rest on him. And behold, a voice from heaven said, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased." Lord, we thank you for the open heaven today. Lord, we thank you that over this prayer room right now, there's an open heaven. Lord, we thank you that wherever anybody is listening or watching, Lord, there's an open heaven over their head. Jesus has made sure of that. He accomplished that through the cross. There is no wall of division between us and God because what you accomplished for us, Jesus. So, Lord, we thank you for the open heaven, Lord. We thank you for everything that you're pouring down. We receive it. We have our arms open, our palms ready to receive. They're wide open, Lord. We thank you for the open heaven that is here. And, Lord, we thank you for this worship that's going up like a fragrant offering to you, that there is no ceiling over top of this worship, Lord, that it's ascending straight into the throne room today, and it's bringing so much pleasure to the heart of our Father. Lord, we thank you for this connection between heaven to earth. We thank you for the connection from earth to heaven, Lord. We say, let your kingdom come, Lord. Let your will be done. Let your presence fall like rain over us today as we worship you, God. Let the Holy Spirit descend like a dove and rest upon us and rest upon each and every person that is watching or listening, God. Lord, the dove remained upon Jesus. And we pray and declare today that the dove of the Holy Spirit shall remain upon each and every one of us. That it's not going anywhere. It's not flying away. That the Holy Spirit is ours. It belongs to us as those saved by the blood of Jesus. And Lord, we listen right now for that beautiful voice of our good Father saying, how well pleased you are with us.
Yes, Lord.
You hear that, church? The Father is well pleased with you. We receive your words, Father. We receive your words.
You're singing over me right now. As heaven is being poured out. Ooh. Come rest on. Fill me.
To a new place. You're doing new things in our hearts, in our minds, in our spirits, in our worlds. Lord, you're doing new things. You're bringing a new wineskin. You're bringing new wine. You're bringing new life. You're bringing new hearts. New minds, the mind of Christ, new creation. That's who you've made us to be, God. You're doing a new thing and we don't resist it. We just follow you into that new place. We follow you in to that new place. For some people, it may feel really intimidating to go into a brand new place, an unknown place. But the good news is Jesus is guiding you as the good shepherd.
Yes.
So Lord, we just yield right now.
Yes.
To this new thing that you're doing. We surrender ourselves and we say, God, take us in deeper.
Yes.
Take us in further to your presence. Take us in to the secret place, God. Take us further than we've ever gone before with you. We want to
yes.
go deeper.
Yes.
We want to explore more of your heart and your presence, God. And so we yield to that right now. We yield to the new things.
Of my beauty. places of trust fall into your arms. This is a trust fall into your arms. I'm gonna trust you'll catch me in your arms while we're doing this new thing right now. This is a trust fall into your arms. Yes, this is a trust fall into your arms. And I'm gonna trust it. You'll catch me in your arms while we're doing this new thing, you and me. Yes, and this is a trust fall into your arms. And this is a trust fall into your arms. You'll catch me in your arms while we're doing this new thing, you and me, oh, 'cause this is a trust fall into your arms, and this is a trust fall into your arms. You'll catch me in your arms while we're doing this new thing, you and me. And I'll lean back, and I will lean back in the loving arms of my beautiful Father. I trust you, Lord, and I will. Surrender all, I give in, I give in.
new place. New place, you're in a new place. The declaration from this moment forward is that we're worshiping from a new place. You've never gone this way before. You've never gone this way before. You're worshiping from a new level, a new dimension, a new place. The Lord has upgraded you today in Jesus' name. We are in a new place, Lord, and we choose to worship you from this new place. God, take us higher, take us deeper, take us further, Lord. We want this to be our new normal. We want encounter to be our new normal. We want to live lifestyles of encounter with the Holy Spirit, where each and every day we hear your voice clearly, where we dream dreams and see visions.
Yes.
Know that you're near and can acknowledge your presence even in the midst of our 9-to-5, God, that we not go anywhere, that we not recognize our intimacy with you. This is a new place that we're in. We're going to worship you from this new place, from this new place. We expect to see something uniquely different, something we've never seen before, because you have picked us up and you have placed us in a new place.
Yes.
A new season.
Yes.
A new place.
Yes.
We put our feet down in this new place,
yes,
Lord. This new territory that you've given to your children today, Lord. We put our feet down here and we say, we're going to proclaim your goodness. We're going to worship you from a new place in the Spirit, Lord.
Take me anywhere. Take me anywhere. Take me anywhere. Yes. Yes. Take me anywhere. Take me anywhere. Take me anywhere.
Yeah.
just to be with you. desperate for you. Right now we're so desperate for you.
Church to a new place, a place where Jesus has all preeminence in every service, in every meeting, in every board meeting, in every staff meeting, where Jesus takes center stage and becomes the center focus of your global church, God. Jesus, make your bride beautiful. We look to you as our example and our definition of what beauty is. And in worship, we lock gaze with you, God, and we ask you, make us like you. Make your bride beautiful as you are beautiful, Jesus. Make your church beautiful as you are beautiful, Jesus. Take center stage again, Lord. We repent for where we have made this all about programs or ministries or assimilation or some other system or structure and forgot to consult the Holy Spirit in the midst of making our plans. God, forgive us for that. Lord, more than anything else, we acknowledge our need for you. If you don't show up, this isn't really church. If you don't show up, it's not really worship. It's just karaoke. Which is not enough for us, Lord. We need your real, vibrant, indwelling presence in our churches, God. We need your spirit moving throughout these buildings, Lord, so that as lost people come in, lost people come home. And not just to an organization, Lord, but they come home to your heart. They come home to real mercy and tangible grace. They come home to a baptism of your Holy Spirit. They come home to an infilling of everything that you poured out on Calvary, God, to fill up their lives. Lord, we receive this new thing, God, and we step into it. And from this new place, Lord, we pull up every single brother and sister that has fallen behind. Every single dormant spirit, we proclaim you are waking up today in Jesus' name. And you are stepping into a new place of desperation upon the Spirit of God. You are stepping into a new dimension of hunger. Jesus is stoking your hunger today. He is fanning the flame to where you are engulfed with passion for His Word again, to where you are exposed to first love again. We welcome you to this new place, body of Christ. Revival hit the churches in America. Revival hit the churches all throughout the nations of the earth. Let a revival of prayer, a revival of worship, a revival of first love be released again. Do a new thing in your body, Lord, all over the world. Do a new thing, Lord. We pray. We pray and declare that you are bringing the church into a new place. Every church, wake up. Step in.
Took the cross and died, and then he began again.
Oh, God.
You began. began again, you began again, you began again, so that I can begin.
Yes, God.
And you began so I can begin. It's time to wake up, wake up, wake up. Begin
us to be born again, that you love making all things new. You love it. You love it. You love it. Lord, show your son, show your daughter right now your great ability to make all things new. You're not lacking in any ability to make any situation brand new. So, Lord, we just say thank you today for this new place that you've brought us to, for this revolution, this restoration, this redemption.
Yes.
Of all things being made new, for this brand new space that you've brought us to, and this new season that you've put us in this new realm, new place of worship and exposure to your presence like never before. This is the new normal. This is the new normal. This is the new normal. In Jesus' name, amen.